those of you that remember the Braves of the 90s and even the Braves in the new millennium, you know, they're always in the mix. They're competitive. You don't know how weird that seems to those of us that grew up in the 70s and in the early 80s. The Braves were absolutely terrible. And I'm not making this up because our team actually did it. You could declare as a Little League coach, I'm taking the entire team to see the Braves play, and you could sit the entire team behind home plate.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The entire team.
No problem. They were horrendous, Rick. I remember one time after they actually defeated the Padres like 2-1, and I remember the announcer saying, well, we're only now 9 games from getting out of the cellar.
Right,
in the National League West, which is where they used to play. And, boy, they had the Dodgers and the Reds. I mean, they had a tough division.
When the Braves were good, that was one of those things I thought, well, Jesus is coming back.
I never thought I'd see it.
Because, I mean, they were absolutely – the baby blue Braves were absolutely terrible. And I remember that your Little League team could go over, sit behind home plate, and meet Daryl Chaney.
And then we would just move around the stadium, sit everywhere you wanted to.
Right.
Let's go try it from first base.
The real art of going to a Braves game back then was to go to see a team you wanted to see come in.
We saw them play the Red Machine.
It was like, you know, the Cardinals.
That was the biggest crowds they had then. That was the big Red Machine, but it would all be Cincinnati people. And I remember
we were Braves fans that wanted to see them.
Yeah, including us. We were for the Reds.
Yeah.
So anyway, Bubba and I, one of the little things we got to mark off our list of things we always wanted to do was to go to a Braves game when they were good and actually be in the play-by-play booth with the play-by-play team and get to call an inning or so with the guys. And one of the voices that was best remembered, and he saw it all from the bad to the good, is Pete Van Wern.
Yeah, Rick, he passed away over this weekend, originally from Rochester, New York. He was known for his affiliation with the Turner teams and the Turner Broadcast Networks. From 76 to 2008, he called the games on TV and or radio. He had a number of on-air partners, Ernie Johnson, Don Sutton, and Skip Carey, most notably. Pete was known as the professor because of his style. And he knew the game, man. He knew the nuts and bolts of it, no doubt. But that, super nice. We got to sit in an inning when we were doing Turner South, and I tweeted that picture out earlier today. But just super nice. I mean, they didn't have to be, but they really, really were.
That was a big honor to get
to do that.
And Pete was my world of when I first got into radio, too. He and Ernie and of course, Skip. Mm-hmm. And the Braves were so terrible. And so a lot of
pitch
you,
just
to pull the curtain back, anytime you're hearing a broadcast of a sporting event on radio, there's somebody at the board, and they've been given this sheet that shows them when the breaks are coming up, local and then network and all this, and, you know, I have my local, you know, of the Braves sponsors that had been, you know, which I don't know how you ever sold them. and I had that up there.
It was just hope, Rick.
So,
it was hope.
So the game would drag on so much.
Yeah.
And so you'd like –
because they'd go through 8 pitchers in a game, you know.
So you would think, okay, the next break is network. So not only do I have this whole inning, I don't have this next break. So this is the time to go to the bathroom. Well, so little would be going on. You'd come back in the studio and you hear Budweiser. Like, yeah, I go, oh my gosh, I've missed a break. Then all of a sudden you'd hear, ball inside.
Yes.
You're like, what did I do?
And then it would be Pete's voice, ball inside. I mean, they got the point, they weren't even doing stories and stuff in between this. It just got.
And Rick, correction, he died last year. This was the anniversary. Oh. That's why they had the specials on about it.
I'm sorry.
It's on me.
Well, you must have really missed Pete.
It was on me. But that's why I saw the specials this weekend. I thought, well, that must be it. Thanks, Don. But it doesn't take away from what you're saying, Rick.
I'm sitting here researching his highlights and stuff just so we can play.
Well, I'd still like to hear him. It's been a year. Everybody knows.
Wait a minute.
August 2nd, 2014.
Yeah, Bo, you did keep up with him a lot.
Wait a minute. Tell me, have you put out on Twitter our picture saying Pete died today?
Where I just said remembering.
Well, see, that's good. That's okay.
Yep. Because it's been a year.
Oh my God, it's just so difficult here.
Rick,
the internet didn't get this one wrong.
They didn't. Just us. Oh, my God.
You know, Rick,
gosh.
I remember Dale Earnhardt.
Greg. I'm just going to hush. There's no way out.
Hey, we're going to talk about old Pete going on.
All right, well, look, here's the good
news. Hey, we missed it by a year.
Listen, here's the good
news. August the 2nd, 2014.
No, here's what I bet you. I bet you this because of this.
See, this is entertainment you can't get on professional shows.
If you
he was dead a year and never.
I didn't know it. No, how about this? I guarantee you. No, this is even worse. Let me give you a double hit on our current state. I bet if you go back to an archive of this day last year,
you think we said something
we were talking about.
Because I don't remember.
So not only we don't remember he died, we don't remember we acknowledged that he died a year ago. I guarantee we did. I bet we set the same picture out too. Hey, I bet we had this picture on the website.
Thank goodness.
How about this?
Thank goodness I put remembering Pete Van Wert.
Oh, me too. See, that sticks. You're still okay there.
Yeah, I wish you'd have put sorry to hear the sad news.
I know. And that's what I was afraid of.
It was a sad day in Braves family.
Look, the good news is it still led to some pretty, I think, entertaining, funny Braves talk.
Oh, my gosh.
Like it did a year ago.
Rick, it was great memories. Great movie.
I bet you we were talking about it.
I think we were probably crying talking about it.
Well, I bet you could find – if you could find pick of the day – August 3rd or 2nd, 2014, I bet it's us with Satan and Pete.
Let's not go back into all that. How about Trump?
How about old Trump? What's he said?
I love how you went in and just shot yourself in the foot.
Here's a text from my pastor. I thought I was listening to a best of show.
Yeah, I got that text.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Just be glad you called yourself out.
Gosh.
At least I got to shoot myself.
Oh,
right?
That does make it, because if one of us would have found it, see, we're so stupid, we believe you too. Dang, Pete's dead.
I mean, my heart was a little heavy.
Not one person said, you know, I think that was last year.
Not one of us.
Because you know why? We don't remember.
No wonder all the documentaries are so well done. I thought, wow, they got them together quick. Yeah.
Rest in peace.
When we come back, the king of rock and roll has passed away.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.